Hi guys and welcome to Uncut. Today we are joined by West Ham's Declan Rice.
We'll be reacting to his FIFA stats.
I'm not happy with it at all. They could all be in the 80s easily, so I think I've been robbed here, to be honest with you.
His Premier League playlist.
Cotton Eye Joe come on, and everyone was going mental. Like, everyone was singing it, like, literally everyone.
And going through some of the stories behind his Instagram posts.
What's the band called?
Backstreet Boys.
Let's get into it.
So Declan, thanks for joining us. How are you? How is the season going so far?
Hello. Yeah, I'm really good, thank you. Yeah, the season's going amazing. As you know, we're fifth in the Premier League at the moment. Been on a great run recently.
The impact that David Moyes had since coming in last year, keeping you up. What has changed from last season to this season that has taken you on to the heights of being in and around the top, you know, 5-6 in the table?
I think just the squad harmony, really. This obviously the manager's second time round now. You know, he came in halfway through last season, so it was tough for him to really implicate his staff. So he had him now for pretty much a full season, and you know, we've got such a great squad of players, and squad of players that, you know, if you don't start, no one's complaining, everyone gets on, got a great team, and you know, as you can see on the pitch, we're fighting for each other. So probably say the biggest thing we've got at the moment is like unity, really. You know, we're all really good friends on and off the pitch, and I think that's showing.
Jesse Lingard's joined.
Yeah.
How has that impacted the squad?
Yeah, he's been a massive impact. You know, he's taken us up another level. We knew his qualities before he came and how good he actually was. I didn't think a few of the players really knew how good he was until they started to train and play with him. But yeah, having him in the team now has made such a difference. And he scored 4 goals in 6 now, so we need to keep him going on a nice run towards the end.
You've got a photo of Mark Noble behind you. You have been using his armband, leading the team out. How has that felt for you?
Yeah, it's been really special. Nobes has been great, really. I think if I didn't actually have him here, we probably wouldn't have been as successful this season. You know, having him around, even though he hasn't played as much, still been a massive impact for everyone.
What does he do, you know, on a regular day-to-day basis in training, even the lead-up into games, whether it be the morning of a match?
His presence is incredible. I think just this whole round, the whole word captain, you know, he's just, everything about him is that, like, when new lads come in, like Jesse, or say when Saeed comes in from Brentford, always on the phone to Saeed, making sure he's sorted with a house, making sure he's sorted with a car. Like, he does all them things out to make sure the lads off the pitch are sweet. Makes him feel really, really comfortable. Like you said before the games as well, you know, he's really vocal, wants the best for everyone, really pushes everyone on. And like you said, half-time, he's giving pointers out as well as the manager. So yeah, he's massive to have in and around the changing room.
Declan, we have to talk about, of course, this is your second time being on Uncut. Last season, of course, we had the cup stacking.
3, 2, 1, go.
Nice and slow. Steady, steady. Soft hands.
13 seconds, 51.
Congratulations, you are number one.
Macy's not going to be happy about this.
Maybe Mason will go again.
And then I'll go again.
Proud to say you are the Premier League Cup stacking champion. I believe you received your trophy.
So good it is. Do you want to see a little preview of the trophy? Do you want to see it?
Yeah, I would, mate. Yeah, I would love to see it.
Just like to dedicate this to my mate as well, Mason Mount, who actually said I would have no chance. I've got no hand-eye coordination. He said I've got no speed.
I'm calling out. Yeah, there's only one person, Declan Rice, West Ham.
Declan Rice?
Yeah.
That's your friend.
Yeah, he will be so slow, I reckon, as well.
Yeah, this one's for you, mate. Buzzing with it. Thanks, Myla.
Hopefully one day we can get you side by side, cups together.
Face off.
Face off.
I'm down. I'm there. I've already won. I'm telling you.
So we're going to go through some of your Instagram posts and discuss them. So the first one is you and the lads on the pitch. It says, the band has arrived. What a win. Was this planned?
Yeah, it was planned. It's not an odd one, because Jesse, when he was at Man United, he'd done the celebration where he's got like the shoe and like, he moves his legs. And then when he come into West Ham, like, we do a game, it's called like the D, like Milo and I, where the keeper pings it out, you got to take one touch and score.
Yeah.
But, like, Pablo scored and started doing it, and Jesse was like crying with laughter, like just that Pablo was doing it. So like before the game, we was in the changing room, Pablo was like, look, if we score today, Jesse, you go on the shoe, you go on the drums, and I'll go on the guitar. So I was like, yeah, sweet. And then luckily enough, Jesse scored, and we done the celebration.
You got Big Suchek, and you've got Jared coming in late. They obviously weren't privy to the conversation that you three had.
Now they weren't away. I think if you look at the picture, Thomas is just staring at us like, what is going on here? And then Jared, he's just looking at us as well, isn't he? So I don't think he had a clue what was going on.
Obviously, Jesse's renowned for the Millie Rock, as you said, dances and whatever. You know, Pablo being Spanish, he's got a bit of rhythm. You, on the other hand, I'm thinking a bit stiff, not much coordination, but you've gone for the drums.
Yeah, it needs work. It does need work. It was a bit stiff, but look, it's my first time drumming.
Well, I'm going to say this to you. Next time, I want a favour from you.
What do you want?
Next time you score, I want to see two scissors for Uncut coming in.
Like that?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
What, across the hair?
Doesn't have to be. It's just, obviously, the show is called Uncut. You're a regular on it. I just want to see two hands. Big cheesy grin, two hands.
All right, cool. I've got you.
Yeah. But, what's the band called?
Backstreet Boys.
That is great.
I've known you a long time.
Backstreet Boys. Oh, man, that took you two by surprise, didn't it? That's decent.
Yeah. Yeah, it just caught me off guard there. Yeah, it caught me off guard.
It's just grabbing it or not.
Who's thought of that?
Mate, you know what? Literally, as soon as I posted the picture, someone commented, Backstreet Boys, and then Antonio done it, and I was like just crying. I was thinking, that's hilarious. So when you just asked that then, I've just said, yeah, Backstreet Boys.
And what, like, did David Moyes say anything?
Nah, I don't think he had a clue.
So the next one is your first goal for England. Caption says, scored that goal a million times over in my head, dream come true. So what were you thinking in this photo? What was going through your head?
When I scored, obviously, it was such an open header. Like, I was so free in the box. I thought I went early, and I actually looked over to the linesman, and I think I enjoyed the moment as much as I probably should have. I think I was a bit, like, I don't know. I was buzzing, of course, after, like, a couple of days after, when it really hits you, you're delighted. But when the goal went in during the game, I thought I was offside. But obviously, when the goal went in and the lads come to me, I was buzzing. But, you know, it would have been much better if the fans were there and I could have actually celebrated it properly. That's the one thing I've always actually said about that goal. But, yeah, it was a special moment.
We've spoken with the Cup Stacking Trophy. The next one is you and your best friend, Mason Mount. Obviously, happy birthday to my brother, Mason. I want to talk about, you know, your friendship. Obviously, you've played together since you were young kids. You recently came out after his goal against Liverpool and you let everyone know what you think of Mason. So I want to talk about how strong is that friendship and, you know, how happy are you, you know, seeing him do well?
Yeah, it's obviously strong as anything. You know, we've been best mates since we was eight, so it's been an unbelievable journey to where we both are now. See, regarding the tweet, I can't have anyone speaking any badness on his name. So I had to say something, I had to defend him. And I was right, that tweet popped off, to be fair. But yeah, look, he deserves everything that comes his way. He's a top player. I think he can go on to another level as well if he wanted to. He's unbelievable. He can go again and keep rising to be one of the world's best. So yeah, no, I'm buzzing for him.
All right, so the last one is you obviously winning Hammer of the Season last season. What did that mean to you?
Yeah, it was special. Really up there with probably one of the best things that, you know, I've achieved so far. The year before I was runner-up. I think the year before that I was runner-up as well. So to actually win it this time round was amazing. You know, to get that trophy, to see who's won it in the past. Just recognition really of a last season wasn't the best season as a team, but I think individually done really well and stepped up. So yeah, I was delighted with that trophy.
I'm going to ask you to pick a soundtrack for each of these categories. So the first one is driving to training. So what song are you listening to when you're driving to training?
Do you know what? It's a weird one for me because, like, I listen to so many different genres. It's like, it could be 7 a.m. I could be listening to drill music. Honestly, I could be listening to rap. I could be listening to slow beats. Like, if I had one to listen to training on the way into training at the moment, it's Drake's new song, Lemon Pepper with Rick Ross. Yeah, honestly, that song is playing 20. I don't want to burn it out. Like, it's a proper summer song, so I might have to stop playing it.
You have to space it out so you don't get fed up with it.
Exactly. That. I'm playing it too much at the moment.
Next one is in the gym. Obviously, you've just come from the gym.
It's always a little bit of little baby in the gym for me. Like, if I put that on, our fitness coach, Dave Billows, he will just turn it off and put on some of his old rubbish, and it is horrendous. And we're all arguing, like, we're all back and forth to the iPad changing the music. We're like, Dave, leave it. And he puts on his old stuff, and we want to put on the new stuff, and he's not having any of it. So half the time, this is rubbish.
Okay, so the next one is pre-match.
Oh, pre-match. Again, it's a little bit of everything, to be honest with you. The kit man's got a little playlist that he puts on. It's pretty much, it's like garage, really. He puts on like garage before the game, which is decent. I'm not really one before the game to like listen to music. Obviously, it's on in the background. Lads have different pre-match stuff where they've got their own headphones in.
Because obviously you've got a wide variety of international players from all different countries.
Yeah.
Like garage music is very British in the sense of like, it's like 100%. London, like, you know. It's like you've got Argentinians, you've got Spanish, you've got Czech Republicans. They've never heard of garage music.
No, they haven't. Not at all. That's why they're probably listening to their own stuff. But for us, it's unreal. I love garage music. I think it's quality.
So obviously, one of the most important ones is, after you won a game, you come into the change room, the manager says his piece. What's coming on?
I think it was when we beat Everton away, 1-0. It was like a massive performance. Cotton Eye Joe come on and everyone was going mental. Like everyone was singing it, like literally everyone. And it was going off and everyone was buzzing. Like then obviously that finished and then we beat Aston Villa away and it come on again and everyone was going mental. And then we beat Spurs and then it come on again. Like literally, so Cotton Eye Joe, if we have a really good win, it's bound to happen.
I'm trying to remember. I don't remember Cotton Eye Joe, the song. What is it?
I'm not singing it. That's only for after the games.
Like, you can talk me through the lyrics of the song.
No, I'm not singing it. Go on, why don't you sing it for me? Don't say you don't know it.
Yeah, I feel like you... the cat now, Joe. I haven't known it a long time ago.
It's so good. Everyone's just buzzing.
Do you know what? I'm trying to picture, like you said, obviously you've got the Backstreet Boys. I just couldn't imagine all, you know, you've got Obana, all these players singing Cotton Eye Joe.
Obana loves it. He honestly buzzes off it. Like, that's what I mean about our squad, why it's so good. Like, literally, you just put it on, turn it up, and everyone's just buzzing. Like, to see it happen is unbelievable, honestly. It's so good.
So this is basically an exclusive. The reason for West Ham's success is Cotton Eye Joe.
Nah, I wouldn't say it's the reason, but I feel like, you know, maybe before the games, lads are thinking after the game, if we win, we might sing Cotton Eye Joe it. So listen, if we win after, we'll be on the Cotton Eye Joe again. Honestly, it's one of the most best things I look forward to.
I love it. Right, last one, Dec, is your chilling out.
I don't really have songs where I would like just chill out. Like, it's just like a playlist, really, where I'd put it on and it would come on again. Like, I'm really into like American rappers, to be fair. I like my English rap. Obviously, Storms. I listen to everyone, really. Like, chilled music for me could be anything. I don't really have a song where it's like really chilled, like slow songs like Chris Brown and all that type of stuff. I'm not really into that type of chilled music.
Yeah, we both know your initiation song before in the past was obviously One Direction.
Is that One Direction? History?
Yeah, you've got a wide variety of music.
That's just because the lyrics are easy. The lyrics are easy to that.
I'm not judging you for sitting at home listening to One Direction.
One Direction are good.
Yeah, exactly.
Four Premier League stars make it into this week's EA Sports FIFA 21 Team of the Week. Manchester City's Kevin De Bruyne earns himself his first in-form of the season. The Belgian midfielder scored twice in an epic 5-2 win over Southampton.
Walker, Foden, De Bruyne, De Bruyne! Oh, superb!
De Bruyne's dribbling and passing stats mean he will be the assist king in any side. Next up is Liverpool's Diogo Jota. The Portuguese scored the only goal in a 1-0 victory over his former club, Wolves.
Little touch from Mane. Jota! He's squeezed it home on the stroke of half-time.
Jota's pace and dribbling have received strong upgrades of 88 and 89, respectively. Kelechi Iheanacho earns his first Team of the Week item after an impressive hat-trick against Sheffield United. The Leicester City forward is in red-hot form after scoring 5 goals in his last 3 matches.
Here's Iheanacho, there are threatening more. Leicester, oh my goodness me! Kelechi Iheanacho has a hat-trick!
Iheanacho is more than capable of replicating his real-life form in-game and would be a smart pick for your ultimate team. Finally, Arsenal's Kieran Tierney picks up an in-form after his performance in the North London derby. The left-back assisted Martin Odegaard for the equalising goal and also made 6 tackles during the match.
Here's Odegaard, and there's the equalising goal!
Tierney will be a popular pick for any side thanks to his lightning pace and physicality. All items are available in-game now. Let me know who you want to pack. Okay, so next, let's react to your FIFA item then. We've got 79 overall.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that?
I'm not happy with it at all.
What are you not happy with?
Meyler, for starters, I could at least be in the 80s. I've been 70 for the last 3 years.
There's room for improvement, Declan.
65 pace. In FIFA terms, probably, yeah, that's right, but that's not right in real life. At least high 70s. My dribble's improving. I would say it's higher than a 69. I wouldn't say it's high 80s. I'd probably say low 80s, high 70s. Shooting 44, to be fair, on FIFA. Real life, not really scored many goals, so I can see where they've got that one from.
That is a terrific hit. An absolutely fabulous goal from Declan Rice.
Defending 78, physical 78, pass 65. They could all be in the 80s easily, so I think I've been robbed here, to be honest with you. I don't know who's actually in control of, you know, writing out these attributes on FIFA. I might have a word.
There is one stat here I need to discuss with you.
Go on.
Your in-game stats, penalties is 30.
I've just seen that, penalties 30. That's shocking, isn't it?
That's poor.
I've only taken one pen though and I've scored, so I'm 100. Touch that. I'm only, yeah, one for one so far, so to be honest with you, that's probably right from what they've judged me on, because before this, I've never even taken a pen. So, you know, hopefully now, towards the end of the season, I get one or two more and that can go up next season.
I can picture it now, Dec. Penalty in your next game, put the ball down the spot, whip it top left corner, off to the corner flag, out comes the celebration. So, we've been obviously been talking about your FIFA stats and whatever. Yeah. What do you think needs to change for FIFA 22?
For starters, the rating of the card, I'm saying at 82.
Okay.
Pace, I reckon we could go up another 10 to 75 at least. I don't think that's being too harsh. Shooting, I reckon, can go up to, it's 44 now. I think it could go up to at least, I can at least put it up 20 to 65 at least. Passing, I think, could go up to an 80, maybe a 75, another 10, 80. Dribbling, I think, could go up to a 79. No, yeah, like a 75 actually, dribbling. Defending, probably like an 81, 82, and physical 81, 82. Nothing too major, I think just little upgrades. But I think last or the year before I had a team of the season card, it was like in the objectives, it was like an 88. It was an absolute beast. People were buzzing off it.
All right, well, that's all we've got time for. Thank you so much for joining us.
Anytime, I really appreciate it.
And lift the trophy up one more time so we can see it. Cup stacking champion.
Champion, shock. Thank you very much.
Do you want to give a dedication speech to Mason or anything?
Nah, I don't need to. I'll just leave it as it is. He knows I'm the champion.
A big thank you to West Ham and Declan Rice. Now, guys, what I want to know is what do you think Declan Rice's rating should be in FIFA 22?
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell so that you don't miss an upload. We'll see you next time.